replace the hazard switch. Having trouble with the directional, it's not flashing. Then you push the hazard and it'll flash. Looking forward to it. I'm get it done. I'm going to use a 10mm to pull out the center console. The fuel door plug-in. I'll plug him in the dark. He's out. And then there's a power outlet to unplug as well. The release pin is on the bottom of mine. Awesome. Come on, baby. Traction control on it. There's a little button to release there. You might want to use a small screwdriver on that. You don't have little fingers. Release that little lock pin. And that should go. There. Okay. And another one over on the side. Pinch, pull, get it out of the way. Seat. Parking brake. Neutral. Ashtray comes out. You use a T15. There's little screws in here. You probably can't see them. They're in there. There's one here, middle behind the ashtray. It's one of those jobs you really, you look at some of YouTube, they look pretty daunting. It's really not that bad. It's just kind of not the most fun, but not the worst thing. Out. A little pry tool or screwdriver and this little panel here, this vent. It's for the heater. It measures the temperature inside the car. Pull the little bezel off of that and there's a screw hiding behind it. So don't forget that. Also 215. One thing about it, you don't need a whole bunch of tools to do this job. 10mm, 7mm socket. T15 Torx. Okay, now my console is undone. Just kind of gently work him out. You have the parking brake on here so you can come out. Oh, and there's another plug behind the cigarette lighter which I have to deal with here. I'm going to push the shift boot through so I got some more rope. There we go. So he flips up. There you can't see it, but it's just a cigarette lighter. Now I'll let the two little clippies pull these out of the way. It's gone. Okay. Now, the hazard switch is up here, so the radio comes out. Or you can unplug it and drop it down, whatever it is. Okay. Now he comes. I'm going to use the gun on that too, huh? We don't have a thing for this. There it is. Yeah, we'll tighten up, save it, moist. He comes out. Out. Yes. Out. Here. And these can stick a little bit. There's a pin in the back on the radio. There's just two screws holding it. There's a pin in the back that locks into a little hole. It's really sturdy. You feel like there's another fastener there, but there really isn't. Once you get it coming, it comes out pretty good. There, like that. Well, kind of gentle. There's an antenna wire you're going to have to undo. Be careful with him. You don't want to mess it up because that'd be a pain in the butt. Having small fingers would be handy at this point. I'm going to cheat. I don't have to use this one. I have a tool. It's a hose removal tool I'm using here. Just going to grab that antenna on the metal part without me. That way I don't mess it up. It's only for hoses, really, but I use it to plug up electrical connectors. And these guys here, you can either take them off, be frustrated later. Okay, there's the clip on that one. I wonder if, you know what? I'm gonna try something. I'm gonna take off the, drop the heater head down too for a little more finger relief. It's only two screws, right? Heater control head. Out, down, radio out, down. And our hazard switch is right here. Now if we can unplug this radio, it's kind of a big walk in. Been on for a few days, so it's kind of stuck. There is a release clip, which is quite hard. Kind of wiggle it. There you go, baby. So it does have a clip, and it is unclipped. Oh, is it two plugs separate with each other? There's the problem. Little plug on the bottom. Bigger one on top. Okay, he's out. Now he's out of the way. There he is. Now we can kind of see. You can't see it, I'm sorry. The hazard switch is right there. I'm going to pop off this little kind of triangular off. Set him over here. There's our pal inside here. Now this guy, I'll show you on the new one. There's a locking pin at the top and bottom. This is at the top and bottom. It's oriented like this in the vehicle with this flat piece on the side. And what happens is you can get at this one and push it with a screwdriver, but the top one stays locked in. People have a heck of a time with it. And what I thought of is just using a feeler gauge. It's a 28 thousandths I've set it for. And I push it in. Now you want to look. See how you got black and the green? So just above the green, you'll slide your feeler gauge in. You'll feel it bump into this fella. Lock. And then just give it a little turn and twist and shove that thing in until it goes in all the way. And then you'll have the top pin released without all that drama that everybody else deals with. It's not going to be the most fun thing you ever done, but it'll go. And then once you've got the top released, you can get at the bottom with a screwdriver of some sort. I'm going to go try this long one here and just push him. And you see it pushes not that hard. And once he's released, it'll go right back out through there. You may have to push the black part with a screwdriver because it'll be in there kind of tight because your feeler gauge will be making it snug. That think this will be the way to go. See, when you look in here, it would be easy to screw up and actually be prying away. I think a lot of people, they get in here and they're prying away here, and you're not going to do a damn thing in here. You're going to make it harder. Because that's just part of the tool, part of the piece. So you got to make sure you're going above that grain. Feeler gauge. Honey. Whoopsies. Actually, mine released and fell into the car, so. Made a liar out of me. I see a lot of guys really working pretty hard to get that unclipped. Okay, so now. Antenna wire. I can feel when it's right there. There's a wire right there. There, also. I have not taken the knee bolster out. But there is room to get your hand up in here and get a hold of it. Just trying to find a place I can put my light where it isn't going to fall out into Never Never Land. Unclip the wire still. I wasn't quite prepared for it to come flying out this easily. This looks interesting. Alright, so now he's out. And I'm going to pull it way down here. Now he's out of here. Unhooked. Now, something I found on all the components is a lot of times these freaking connectors are worn out. And I've got a tool, this is the same size as the pin. I can just feel and see if they're loose or draggy or dirty. No, I feel a little, just a little tension on each one, just like it should be. Nice, 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 nice. And this is a connection improver. It's tiny, expensive, but you know what? Might just make things work better. It cleans, leaves kind of lubricant on the thing. Ouch. Oh, I set it over there. Okay. I plugged in the good one. As you can see, the four ways are flashing. Stop. This is the bad one over here. I don't want to mix them up because it'd be a shame to put it all back together and realize you put the broken part back in. Not the first time, but just a ducky day there. Okay, so now I've got this part down here. It was beside the knee bolster. I'm going to run my hand up inside of here. I'm going to want that to be like this with the big knobs on the right. Then reassemble. Find it, put your finger in the hazard hole to find the ouch, switch. Help him find his way into the hole. And really, there's a pretty decent amount of room around my hand here. I'm not. I've had my hand in some worse places than this. Hey, honey, there's a brace that's kind of in your way. You could really live without that. That's what it is. Okay, honey, grab in there, get it. In the right hole, get it. Okay, I'm gonna slide you over a whisker. Pull you in. Honey, you're doing too difficult, huh? I'm not in the hole. Make sure you're in the right hole. That goes better. Got it. And you hear it snap. And she's good. Look at it and make sure it looks, yes, it looks just like it should. It's all snappered in there. And you're ready to reassemble. Make sure that you test all your connections, particularly your fuel door and everything, as you're assembling it, to make sure you've plugged everything in good, because you don't want to take it back off. And you're good to go.